May of 1984. May 14th, 1984. I just turned 19. So I was 19 and by 2 weeks. When I actually tested, it was late 1983 when our testing process started. You know, if you think back, for those that are older than y'all two are, if you look back in all the technology changes, we went from our gear that we wore was just minimal, there was no standards on it, you know, to now everything is being inspected and it's got a lifespan. The technology of all the things like computers and all that kind of stuff, we had no computers. All the record keeping was handwritten in a logbook. You know, we didn't have microwave ovens. You know, we had cable TV got installed, and I remember that the in the fire stations, and you had a long cord with the control box, and it had a long all the channels that you just flipped across back and forth. So that tells you how long ago it was. Yeah, nothing wireless. You know, as a firefighter, I was lucky enough to have made two saves in my career, received two awards for life-saving, and I know that there are a couple of people alive because of the actions that I took on those two separate occasions back earlier in my career. You know, and if you can make a difference in one life and in your whole lifetime, it's great, but if you can know that you truly made a difference in several, then you know that's for sure. That's a great thing. And then, as I moved up and when I came into the job as chief, assistant chief or chief, I think that my proudest accomplishment was being able to lead such a great group of men and women, and being fortunate to work alongside them, not being their boss, but being there alongside them. And we made quite a few changes in the last several years. We now have a group of men and women that can respond anywhere in the United States, and we're looked upon very highly, not only in the state but in, you know, across the southern United States. Our firefighters are up there with the best of the best. And you know, we did a lot of technology improvements and improvements in programs and things like that in my short tenure. I'm really proud of that accomplishment. The camaraderie, you know. So I spent 28 years living at the station, a third of my life. So that third of my entire adult life from the age 19 all the way up was, you know, spent with that other family. And so you have two real families. You have your real family that's by blood and by marriage, and then you have your firefighter family. When I went into administration, then I kind of lost a little bit of that, but there's still always that camaraderie. And that's probably what, if you ask any retired firefighter anywhere, it doesn't matter where they're at, is the camaraderie, the station, working alongside people and all that. But I'm lucky enough to start a new job, a new career that is kind of in that same realm. So I'll be working for the Texas A&M Forest Service and be managing the incident management team and TIFNAS programs for the state of Texas. Man, thick skin, you know. You can't let the vocal minority dictate the way that, you know, that not the way that you govern, but kind of the way you govern, you know. So like any other organization, you've got a few naysayers, but by and large, if you do what's best for the firefighter safety and what's best for the city and the citizens, and that person will do fine. So just keep that in mind.